Hey there, fellow fans of Cobra Kai. My name is Christian, and I'm from Denmark. And in case you shouldn't have guessed it from the title of the video, this one is all dedicated to my secretively planned Cobra Kai Season 3 binge party, which I held for two brothers and a bunch of friends. Now, this video does require some setup and context for you guys out there to truly follow along and hopefully enjoy it, even though you weren't personally here. So what you need to know is that for a whole year, the only thing my party knew was that they'd be coming over, just like with season 2, and we'd sit down, have a couple of beers, and binge the season together. That's all they knew. What they did not know was that I had bought a 4K projector, a 150-inch screen to display the image on. I had managed, over the course of a year, to gather in so many personal greetings from the cast and crew, including a great, wonderful intro greeting to season 3 from John Hurwitz himself, one of the wonderful three big creators of this amazing show. And thanks to my girlfriend, God bless her soul, she completely allowed me to f*** up the apartment for one night only. I did a lot of stuff out in the hallway and out in the kitchen, and most of all in the living room where we watched the show. And for the night, that was called Christian's Dojo. I completely emptied out everything in the living room. I put up black on the walls, on the ceilings, and totally tried to immerse us in the world of Cobra Kai and Karate Kid just for this one night. Now, I held this binge party on Saturday the 9th of January. Yes, a week after the new release, because when Netflix announced that they had moved the release date to January the 1st, which was a great treat for fans, of course, but at that time it was too late for me to do anything about that. We needed to stick to the original date for this binge party. I had so many balls rolling already. So we all decided to do that, bury our heads in the sand, and only see it when we were together, and it paid off. It was amazing. Now, the footage you're going to be seeing, the video I created, is all from pretty much from the perspective of my friends and brothers. It's their footage because I couldn't have the phone out the entire night. I was the host and I wanted to be there in the moment as much as possible and enjoy it in the moment with them. So I tried to put it all as much as I could in context and truly try to bring you guys out there along for the ride as best as possible and just give you a little sense of what it was really like. Without further ado, let's just dive into this thing, and we're gonna start with some footage I shot the day prior to the party. You'll see it's pretty self-explanatory. So if you're still with me, thanks for watching, and let's dive in. Okay, guys. Now, my guests will be coming up those stairs tomorrow. And of course, it's gonna be daytime, so I'm gonna be covering that, so it's gonna be dark up here. They're coming up the stairs, and they're gonna be greeted to this. So you can see that even the static you've been hearing has a purpose. They're gonna be seeing this, and I'm gonna put it on play just before they come up. And I'm gonna have a coarse banquet broken bottle here. And they're gonna see this countdown. I just follow me here, all right? So it's all about the mood. It's all about the atmosphere. And when that countdown hits zero, there's gonna be something else, and then a personal message from me about what they're gonna be doing when they, you know, get inside the hall. And this is my, of course, my door that's gonna be covered with posters. Check this out.
Specials on all of our inventory. Every customer leaves.
Okay, now a personal message from me they're going to be seeing.
Good afternoon, students. Listen carefully, because this will only be played once. After this message, and just before you ring that dojo bell, you are ordered to take off your shoes and leave them outside. Just for now.
Nice trailer voice.
Also, Take off your jackets and have them ready in hand to hang on the coat rack once you've entered. Then, you will proceed directly down the hall and straight out into the kitchen, which for this day is called...
Grease's Place.
And that was that. You may now do as you've been told. See you on the inside.
And then, of course, they're going to be doing that, and then they're going to walk inside the hall. Can you recognize the music playing right now? It's Kreese's military music from Karate Kid 3. And I had this playing from a little speaker when we let the guests inside the hallway, and also it played out in the kitchen on what I called the Cobra tube, which was basically just a TV I had put in vertical stand. And then they were greeted to this welcome message.
Hello, students from Denmark.
What?
This is Martin Cove, a.k.a. John Kreese. In a few moments, Christian's dojo will be open. But before you go in, you're going to get a welcome shot from the Cobra Pit. Remember, mercy is for the weak. Here and on the streets, someone confronts you, he is your enemy, even during a lockdown. Because an enemy has no mercy. Just sweep the leg.
Not belong.
Pretty epic, right?
Okay, Christian, what the?
What?
Så er der ikke corona, der er cobronas. Det er
cobrona.
So that's me up on screen letting my guests know about some ground rules for this party and basically tells them to enjoy this day to the fullest. Next is where I shut myself up and we head into a little montage I edited with some of those bits I'll also let you witness now.
Now, initiated will be the official countdown to season 3.
Yeah!
What comes up now was also a part of the pre-show slash countdown, and I had a lot of fun with the creativity. Note, Michael is one of my brothers.
How are you all feeling there in Christian Still Joe? May I have your attention, please? In a few moments, we're gonna have a special video coming up for a Michael Crow.
Oh, great. Now somebody else is gonna steal my spotlight?
It is gonna be amazing, so stay tuned.
What the f***?
What's this?
Hi, David. Super fans of Cobra Kai. It is Vanessa Rubio. I play Carmen Diaz on Cobra Kai. And I'm wishing you all a very good, happy screening over there in Christian's dojo.
What?
You know how that goes. I also wanted to throw a little extra love to Steinman. The one and only Queen Cobra Kai member in your party. I know you're surrounded by a lot of testosterone, and I just wanted to tell you, as a female member of the Cobra Kai cast, that I'm right there with you, in spirit, at least. Well, that's it for me. Oh, and your boyfriend also wanted me to tell you that he loves you very much.
Aww.
Awesome. How amazing is that? So anyway, that's it for me. I hope you guys enjoy season 3. I'm wishing you all a happy new year, and bye-bye.
Donut shops, throwing away fritters. But you keep your paws off my bounty.
You just be homeless somewhere else.
You taking me home, baby?
Yeah, you wish.
Wow!
Hey there, everybody. My name is Susan Gallagher, also known as that sassy homeless Lynn in Cobra Kai on Netflix. Me and Lynn want to welcome all of you to Christian's Dojo. And listen, no matter how big or small the part is here on Cobra Kai, all of us for sure are super grateful for you super Danish fans, and we love you all, and we're appreciative of how much you guys support us and the show. Lynn is going to be watching season 3, and I know you guys are going to enjoy season 3 in Christian's Dojo. And just remember, I ain't going to hurt you.
After this was when the video I'd created for my older brother came up on screen, the one I teased a bit earlier. Here's what you need to know. We are all martial artists in real life, and back in 2019, my brother won the Danish championship. For this occasion here, I'd edited together all of his matches from that day in fast-paced Cobra Kai fashion, complete with score and a green color palette, as you'll see. No one, including him, had ever seen this thing cut together like this, but more than anything, I knew it would be the greeting after that video from a certain someone that would absolutely floor him. So without further ado, here we go.
On winning the 2019 Karate Championship. That's really amazing. And according to your kid brother Christian, he said it was a hell of a win. And if everything he's saying is accurate, well, I might actually have to reconsider who's the baddest bad boy of karate.
Okay, so it might be unfair of me to be irritated over this, but their applause was so loud that it drowned out Sean's punchline. So I'm gonna insert it for you here instead.
Well, I might actually have to reconsider who's the baddest bad boy of karate. Mike Barnes or Mike Crow? I don't know.
I still think your karate's a joke.
For the final bit of the countdown, a cast interview came on, which ended like this.
Hey everyone, John Hurwitz here, co-creator of Cobra Kai. The wait is finally over. You get to see season 3 right now. I know I've been waiting for a long time for you guys to be able to see it. It's been driving me crazy. I'm sure you've been desperate to find out what's gonna happen with Miguel, Johnny, Daniel, everybody. It's our biggest and best season yet. I think you're gonna love what you're about to see. I wanted to give a shout out to Christian. I know that he's brought a lot of joy to myself and all the members of the Cobra Kai family with his amazing artwork and his videos. And you should all appreciate what he's put together for you today. I know that he's put a lot of work into this. It's something that he's been discussing with me online for months and months now. This is something that's meant a lot to him, and I hope you guys are all enjoying it. And Christian, I think you better put a ring on that finger of your girlfriend, because what she's allowed you to do to the apartment, she's definitely a keeper. All right, everybody, have a great time, have fun, and enjoy season 3.
Swallowed whole by the thrill of the fight. It wasn't for the money, and it wasn't just for fun. I wanted to make a mark, I just wanted to be someone. I heard the devil whisper in my ear, he made his message clear when he said, sweep the leg, Johnny.
Hey students, Billy Z here, aka Johnny Lawrence from Cobra Kai. How's it kicking over there in that Danish town known as Cockadale?
It never really mattered, I was always under control. Monkey here, monkey think, there is no fear in this dojo. I was a superhero, king of 1985. I showed no mercy, I was always Cobra Kai. But I caught a crane kick to the face.
Hello there, you people from Denmark. This is Tom Cruise, a legend with all the right moves. There is no substitute. Woo! And I know what you're thinking right now. Tom isn't part of the Karate Kid universe. Well, no, I'm not, but that's irrelevant. And I just had to drop in and tell you all that I was a little hurt. Okay, I'm not gonna lie. I wanted to express the sorrow that I'm feeling, deep sorrow that I wasn't invited to Christian's Cobra Kai free binge party. Yeah, that's right. News travels fast, guys. Now, I know who all of you are, too, because I mission impossible my way to a complete list of those in attendance. So, hello there, Michael, Thomas, Marv, Kim, Jacob, the two Mortons of the party. There's always two of them. Not to forget Christian's lovely girlfriend, Stina. I mean, she never lose that loving feeling. I mean, she takes all her breath away. Right? Anyway, I hope you're enjoying those pina quebrados you're drinking there, because I sure as heck can't from over here. Now, I would have been on my private jet in a second, flying inverted, landing right in the middle of that Danish town known as Cogendale, but I never got an invitation. Now, did I? Now, maybe you got lost in the mail. Who knows? But don't worry. I'm not going to do what you all think I'm going to do, which is just flip out! No, sir. No, sir. I'm calm and clear. Crystal clear. Because I'm Tom Cruise. So enjoy the rest of your binge party, fellas. The bar is open. Cocktails and dreams. And we are in this together. Fates intertwine, cosmic coincidence. You are my ambassadors of Kwan, my rock of ages, my last samurais, and you complete me. Now maybe I'll see you in another life when we're both cats. Thomas Day.
Thomas Day.
Johnny, sweep the leg, Johnny.
Johnny. Oh, good God, now you gotta believe me.
How lucky can one guy be? I kissed her and she kissed me. Like the fella once said, ain't that a kick in the head? The room was completely black. I hugged her and she hugged back. Like the sailor said, quote, ain't that a hole in the boat? My head keeps spinning. I go to sleep and keep grinning. If this is just to be.
Hey there, students of Denmark. This is Ralph Macchio here, sending you my best. I know you guys are big Cobra Kai fans watching the series, probably having your own after party.
Everybody who worked on the Cobra Kai season 3, holy balls, this was the best season yet. And I'm speechless. And my bros event, I think we were all speechless, and thank you very much for all the kind words and all the video posts. You can imagine how my Instagram stories are blowing up. So thank you. Best season yet. I can't wait for season 4. Holy mother. Game of Thrones, go home. And I love that. But I love this more. Let me just say again. Holy f***. That was nice.
Greetings in Denmark. Greetings, Christians Dojo. Greetings, Shingo Ru Karate. How are you guys doing? This is Sensei Ron Thomas. You know me as Bobby Brown.
But I'll be disqualified.
Or Pastor Bobby Brown on the new hit series Cobra Kai. Christian tells me that... Well, Christian tells me a lot of stuff. Christian tells me, first of all, that you guys are having this binge watch party over there in Denmark on a 150-inch screen in what's being called Christian's Dojo. What? 150-inch screen? I want to drink the water that Ralph Macchio is drinking. I want the youth pill that Ralph Macchio is taking, because that guy never ages. So on a 150-inch screen... Yeah, I hope you don't see that wrinkle. I got a new one. Christian also tells me that, yeah, you guys are real martial artists, that you train in, I guess the name of the dojo is actually Shingo Ru Karate. Is that true? I'm a 6th-degree black belt in jiu-jitsu, and I was a world champion, and I owned a couple schools, actually, in Los Angeles, and trained a lot of other world champions in the art of sport jiu-jitsu, Kodenkan jiu-jitsu. You know, what else can I say, man? It's so awesome for me to be sending messages like this halfway around the world to Denmark to fans like you who are fans of Cobra Kai and Karate Kid, and hopefully you're fans of Bobby Brown too, right?
You gotta be. How can you not be a fan of Bobby, the good bad guy? I hope you guys enjoy the rest of the night. I hope you guys are having a blast watching Cobra Kai, and I'll leave you guys alone, man, because I know you've had enough. Peace out.
There's nothing you got that I can't counter. Your karate's a joke.
Let the party begin. Let the party begin, LaRusso.
The entire day and night was absolutely incredible, and it went by way too fast. Now, I will have my own in-depth review of Season 3 coming sometime down the line, and I don't care if I'm way late to the party on that one, because I simply want it to be done justice, and it'll also be made in sort of a special kind of way, so be on the lookout for that one. But for now, let me just say that Season 3 was hands down the best and most ambitious season yet.
John Cannon again, just had to drop in one more time. I wanted to give a shout out to Thomas.
I understand you just had a son named Sebastian. That's incredible. And I hear you named him after a dear friend, and I'm so sorry for your loss. If he's anything like his dad, I'm sure he's gonna grow up to be a hell of a badass. Just wanted to wish you all the best, and I wanted to tell you that, guys, enjoy the rest of season 3. You never know who you might see.
So we are now inside of the bathroom, which for the night will be called Miyagi's Sanctuary. And I chose the color green in here, you know, because of the bonsai. And I went with a white theme, very clean white theme as much as possible, except for the mirror, as you'll see. But it's pretty small, so I'm going to take this slow. This is usually the shower. And every original Karate Kid fan will recognize this. Do notice the gone fishing line, which is something I added to the poster, and that's gonna pay off in a little bit. So, need I say more about that? And then we go over to this. The original All Valley Karate Championship 1984 registration papers. We move over here to a giant picture of Naruyoshi Miyagi, and I used the date of death from the Cobra Kai series. Pretty beautiful, right? That's a fake bonsai tree, but it still looks neat. Beloved husband, father, teacher, and war hero, 442nd Regiment, received Medal of Honor, and check this out. A splattered fly. Sorry, I just couldn't help myself. So we move up to the bathroom door. We have the gi here. That is actually in color, but it's kind of hard to see because of the green light, but whatever. And we move over to this, over the sink. Mr. Miyagi's little trees, just a little drawing. And we have the frame here. Hey guys. Just a little bit of me, and logos here, and Miyagi soap, and check this out, little nerd detail, the white little cloth, check this out, Miyagi-Do Karate School pin, and we move over here. Oh, by the way, that is an iPad that is currently and will be playing the music you're hearing now. In a loop, seamlessly, the entire night. I have it set for like 6 hours playback, so it just goes on and creates the mood and atmosphere. And here we have the original newspaper clipping of Daniel's first major win. I've added some fun details myself. One reads, after Bobby pleads for Daniel's forgiveness, out on the sidelines, witnesses claim to have seen Cobra Kai Sensei clap at Bobby's actions. And also, Johnny, being a real champ, hands LaRusso the trophy. And here is a certificate from the Miyagi-Do Karate School. And yes, that is Julie Pierce. Need to pause this for a second, because I know what most of you are thinking right about now. Julie Pierce? Really? Yes, really. Now you can think what you want about the next Karate Kid, but Hilary Swank as Julie Pierce sure as heck weren't the problem. The Cobra Kai series would be lucky to get her on board for the show at some point in the future. They not only could, but would, do brilliant things with Julie Pierce, and having a powerhouse actress like Hilary to flesh out that character would be gold. Here's my prediction, and you can quote me on this in the future if you want. All of you who have a problem with the next Karate Kid after seeing what things will be done with Julie Pierce within the world of Cobra Kai, most of you will suddenly go, okay, I never really liked the next Karate Kid, but I have to admit, Julie Pierce is f***ing awesome within Cobra Kai. Sorry, moving on now.
So, if we move to the wall, we have some Polaroids here made by me. Let's start with this one from Karate Kid 1. I love that girl, and I swear to God, if she doesn't show up in season 3, I'm gonna hurt someone. She's beautiful, but so is she. And I actually photoshopped Miyagi in front of Sato there, because, you know, they became friends and they look good together. They were friends, enemies became friends. They needed to be there together. Also, another cool image from Karate Kid Part 3. And again, fellas, you might as well accept it. It is gonna happen. So here, we have a toilet. And you might think it's kind of weird why I'd be showing you that, but you won't think that way after I put up the lid.
This is Miyagi Spirit, sending you message. Ever since 84, I keep dirty secret from Daniel-san, hidden behind left slide door, inside cabinet above toilet. Remember again to slide glass door shut. Daniel-san must never find out. It would break his heart. Oi, Miyagi feels so bad now.
So, if we do as instructed, we move up to this thing here, and we slide the left door over to the right. What do we have in here?
Dear Mr. Miyagi, you crazy old fart. The picture, which you might want to keep hidden in the envelope, is from all of us to you. Thanks for being a secret Cobra Kai lover. Still can't believe you actually convinced Danielle that you had just gone fishing all of those times when he was training alone. Ha ha. Thank you for the memories this fall. We loved hanging with you too. But don't tell Sensei Kreese. See you at the tournament. We'll try to keep a straight face. Love, Johnny. Do note the date when Johnny wrote this letter. It was the day before Daniel's birthday, which is on the 18th, and 2 days prior to the tournament, which means that Miyagi, in my mind, received this letter on Daniel's birthday, the day before the tournament.
And what is this? It's the envelope which that letter back in the days came in. And I decided to go with a Rocky III stamp I created myself. I wanted to go with Iron Eagle, but of course, as I came to realize, Iron Eagle didn't come out until 2 years after the events of Karate Kid 1. So Rocky III it was. And let's see what kind of picture that Johnny send to Mr. Miyagi. Miyagi, a secret Cobra Kai lover. Oh, I thought it was pretty funny. And that's it, guys. That's the bathroom. And I don't know, I think I did a pretty good job in the creativity department with what I had to work with. So yes, that's the bathroom for the night. And I sure hope everything goes well tomorrow.
This is it. This is the end of the line. You're telling me.